Now, the five-game challenge between Korea's Baduk grandmaster Lee Se-dol and the AlphaGO supercomputer has concluded with machine beating human 4-1. Now, this high-profile event doesn't just leave us with a winner and a loser, but rather it's left us with unlimited possibilities in terms of human ingenuity and the future of artificial intelligence. Man versus the machine or man with the machine? News feature tonight with Lee Ji-won.
After 5 long hours and 280 moves, Lee Se-dol resigned. The 5-game challenge between Korean grandmaster Lee Se-dol and AlphaGO came to an end on Tuesday, with AlphaGO winning 4-1.
People will continue to debate the competitors' move and how each won, but the meeting of artificial intelligence and human intelligence has left us with more to think about.
This tournament is the first competition between an AI system and a top-level professional player, which is why it gained global attention even before it started.
I believe this is the first step towards battles between mankind and AI. It's going to write a new history for both Baduk and artificial intelligence.
AlphaGO's advanced programming had opinions split over who or what would emerge as the champ. But when the supercomputer took the first game, there was still shock.
Many people thought AlphaGO had the advantage, but half the people who know Baduk thought Lee Se-dol was going to win, so they were very surprised at the outcome.
Some didn't think AlphaGO could beat Lee Se-dol, but now that it has, they're starting to think that AI has outsmarted humans in Baduk, like it did with the game of shogi or Japanese chess.
And as AlphaGO continued to rack up wins, it marked a turning point in how Koreans view artificial intelligence.
At first, I thought AlphaGO was just lucky in the first game. But as the tournament progressed, I was surprised to see what it was actually capable of.
It's surprising to see that artificial intelligence can compete with human intelligence, and at the same time, it's also a little scary.
Artificial intelligence could sound like something in a science fiction movie, but in reality, it's everywhere in our daily lives. Google Translate, for instance, is an AI program that uses an algorithm that employs a combination of neural networks and deep machine learning to recognize letters and words, find the appropriate meaning, and do a translation. Driverless cars are perhaps one of the most controversial applications of artificial intelligence that's in development and on the way to commercialization.
But all of these advancements have raised the question of how much should humans rely on AI, as well as the fear that AI could eventually take over humanity.
One obstacle to commercialization of autonomous cars is a concerning possibility of accidents and whether human safety is at risk. The AI devices developed so far are weak, meaning it does not have consciousness, sentience, and mind. So while it may be exact in its calculations, situations that go beyond its database and algorithm will shake its system. And that's exactly what happened when AlphaGO lost to Lee Se-dol in the fourth match, where the computer got flustered by one of Lee's moves and then it made a fatal mistake.
Through the latest Baduk match, many were amused at how smart artificial intelligence has become. But that doesn't mean we should worship it. In the end, humans created these machines, and we shouldn't fear them, but use them as a tool.
Experts added that instead, we should focus on creating a set of ethical regulations to make sure that we're ready to fully use the resources when they become available. Because in the end, it's all the more for humanity.
We do not know who will win, but we know that at the end, humans will be smarter, that the world will be a much better place.
Lee Ji-won, Arirang News.